Justin Kutcher, Eric Crouch up here, Darius Walker down the sideline. This right now is a blowout in favor of West Virginia. So, Eric, what are you trying to do right now, trying to accomplish here in the fourth quarter if you're Marshall and if you're West Virginia?
Well, if you're Marshall, you've got a young team. And in having a young team, you've got to prepare them for the rest of the season. So when you're out there doing the things that you do, mixing it up on offensively, you have to go out and you have to teach your guys to be able to deal with adversity and come back from something like this and not give up.
Geno Smith going deep, has his man McCartney, and McCartney brings it down to the 4-yard line. Derek Thomas there on the coverage. 52-yard play. So what were you saying? Take
Derek
a chance if you're West Virginia?
Tough day out there. Put the ball right where he needed to be. Great throw over the top of his shoulder. Maybe could have led him a little bit more, but I think they're going to be happy with that result.
Geno Smith is now over 300 yards on the day in the air. Smith going to the end zone, lobs it up. Bailey, nice catch for the touchdown.
Geno Smith really doing a great job. Get his chin up, standing as tall as he can, using that big frame to make an accurate throw. Really nice to be thrown to Stedman Bailey, a guy that he really understands and knows, and the timing between them is just impeccable.
Second touchdown catch of the day for Bailey. Tyler Bittencourt on for the extra point. Extra point is good. Well, people have Geno Smith in their top five for Heisman Trophy candidate. 32 of 36, 323, 4 touchdowns, no interceptions. His second connection with his high school teammate, Stedman Bailey. Right now, this West Virginia team is riding the right arm of Geno Smith. 323 yards, 4 touchdowns, only 4 incomplete passes all game long. He has been just supremely impressive in this game. The return by Andre Snipes Booker up to the 28-yard line. Fox College Saturday kicks off later today with Hawaii taking on top-ranked USC. Fans, we want to hear from you. Vote on the College Football Social Poll of the Week. Are the Trojans deserving of their number one ranking? Log on to Facebook.com/Fox Sports to cast your vote. The results will air in the Fox College Saturday post-game show. Post-game show features Aaron Andrews, Eddie George, Joey Harrington. A big day of college football here on Fox. On first down, the handoff to Stuart Butler. And Butler, one of the freshman running backs, gets a carry. Kyle Rose with the tackle.
I think this might be an opportunity to really open up your offense at this point in the game.
Oh, you don't want to be conservative right now?
I don't think so. I don't think there's any reason to.
Down 42, you don't want to play it safe. Antavius Wilson on the catch. Up to the 44-yard line, a pickup of 14. But just think about this. When speaking with Marshall's defensive coordinator, Chris Ripon, we asked him, you know, thoughts on facing West Virginia. He said, first thing you think about is 70 points, what they did in the Orange Bowl. Well, I guess second thing you think about is 62, what they've done so far through essentially three quarters.
Yeah, you know, defensively, you know, they had some question marks. They've got some young secondary guys that have come from other programs, and they don't understand quite yet what the whole thing about Marshall is. And I think they, being such a short camp and coming in, it's going to take them time to understand that and really fit into the schemes that the defensive coordinator is trying to run.
Cato rolling out. The pass is tipped and intercepted. Doug Rigg. Rigg trying to go with a stiff arm across the 5 and wrestled down by Rakeem Cato. A 46-yard interception return.
Cato really just doing everything that he can, except he had a little bit of a behind-the-receiver pass and got a little tipped and just doing everything he can to make sure that he's not getting in the end zone right there.
Got to be careful, too, of the horse collar tackle. But the intended receiver was Eric Fronapolis, tight end, thrown behind him. And then there was Doug Rigg. A new quarterback into the game. It is Paul Millard, a sophomore from Texas, replaces Geno Smith.
I don't think he's ever been in a game yet.
Lofts one to the end zone. Did he have his foot in? Yes, touchdown, KJ Myers. How's that for your first pass?
What a way to start your career. Perfect throw. We've seen a few of those in the end zone over there.
Third career touchdown pass by Millard. Not a bad way to start off the 2012 campaign as a backup quarterback to a Heisman candidate.
Not at all, but these are the type of reps that he needs in case something does ever happen to Geno Smith this year.
69-20. Didn't we just see this play on the last drive?
We sure did. They put it right in a position where there's only one person that can catch that ball. That was J.D. Woods.
69-20, West Virginia all over Marshall.
It's Lieutenant Colonel John Dowling, serving with the 316th ESC, alongside Specialist Adam McGinnis, Major Keith McGee from Section 202, Lieutenant Colonel Rich Sayre with the Mountaineer Athletic Club here at Camp RF John Kuwait, saying, let's go, Mountaineers!
Well, I think right now they are very happy to see what's been going on. 69-20. West Virginia leading here in the fourth quarter over Marshall. And the kick is taken by Stuart Butler about 3 yards deep, returns it, and Butler will get up to the 25-yard line. Well, let's check out today's Reese's perfect play.
Sean Alston getting the handoff. Lineman blocking downfield, doing everything they're supposed to. Leg drive, powerful lean, getting in the end zone for a touchdown. He's had a great big day.
Alston on the day, 123 yards on 16 carries. Two touchdowns in the game. That is our Reese's perfect play of the game. There is a player down on the field for West Virginia. Marshall will start at their 25. Cato on first down, hands off to Stuart Butler. Butler was hit initially in the backfield, his second effort, able to pick up a yard. J.B. Loggeman able to get penetration into that backfield.
Really see West Virginia's defense with a lot of energy still. Could be the score. That might have a little something to do with it. But I don't see that same energy in the beginning of the game that we saw from Marshall's offense.
Cato stepping up. Dancing around, throws. Nice job by Cato to create some space. Completes the pass to Jermaine Kelson. And Kelson was marked down. A pickup of 17.
Nice job by Cato using his feet, getting out of the pocket, and making an accurate throw downfield.
The Mountaineer, it's like the Oregon Duck. I can't do anymore. It's hot. We've scored a lot of points. Cato stepping up, dumps it off to Butler. And Butler is able to pick up another first down.
Smart decision by Cato. Nothing was downfield. Didn't have anything that he really wanted downfield. Came back to his running back, dumped it off.
I guarantee you that outfit's not exactly breathable.
Doesn't look like it.
It's not dry fit.
It isn't a dry fit. He's still angry. I think he still wants more points. He wants more challenging push-ups.
Again, it's Butler on the carry. Able to dance forward, pick up three. Christian Brown on the stop. Well, looking forward, this West Virginia team, they actually have next week off. Then they travel to D.C., take on James Madison. Back home against Maryland. Then they open up Big 12 play at the end of the month against Baylor. And a lot of talk about this West Virginia team, about where they and how they stack up in the Big 12. And Eric, how do you think they stack up in the Big 12?
Well, I really think the preseason rankings got it about right. I mean, you got Oklahoma, who they ranked number one, and then next is West Virginia. And they've done that because of what they're able to do offensively, how they fit into the Big 12. They're a big play offense. Their defense has really only been their question mark. Who's going to step up as leaders on this defense? How are they going to react to when they get in the Big 12? But you know what? They've seen this offense in practice all the time. So I think that pace is not going to be a big change to them.
Right.
Eric Fronapple, the tight end, makes the catch, and he picks up the first down. So we told you about the next three games. Their first road game of the season is at number 15, Texas. Then they're back home against Texas Tech. And look, Dana Holgorsen, he is no stranger to the Big 12. Spent 8 years at Texas Tech, and then he was at Oklahoma State. His defensive coordinator just came over from Oklahoma State. So they have an idea of what happens in this conference.
Well, if after watching what you saw today happen on the field from West Virginia defensively and offensively, there's no question that they're going to do well in the Big 12.
On second and five, a flag is thrown.
5 yard penalty, second down.
Second down coming up. Darius, what's the update on the injuries?
Yeah, guys, Level, you saw him just come off the field with a knee injury. He's classified as a knee injury, but he is done for the day. So we won't see any more Level.
Cato, the slant, pass complete, touchdown for Tommy Shuler. A flag is thrown, though. Let's see if this one is coming back.
Offside, defense, number 53. A penalty's declined, touchdown.
It is a touchdown for Tommy Shuler. Shuler, a sophomore out of Miami, Florida. Rakeem Cato out of Miami, Florida. And now Justin Haig on for the extra point. 69-27. Rakeem Cato getting some more experience in this one. Completes the pass to Shuler, who's able to muscle in for the touchdown. West Virginia on top. Two teams right there. Alabama and LSU played for the national championship. On the kickoff, this one goes out of bounds, which will draw the flag.
Free kick out of bounds. By rule, ball be placed at the 35-yard line, first and 10.
Next week, the regular season begins with a Fox NFL. It'll be a delayed handoff to Bowie, and Bowie spins away from a tackler. Ripped away from Raheem Waiters, Dominic LeGrand with the tackle.
Bowie with a nice spin move there, and I'm still noticing late in the game here, Marshall is still trying to tackle up by the shoulder pads. You know, not gain that leverage and that power and leg drive you get when you tackle someone low. You know, the one thing that you can do too is if you wrap it up low, that keeps them from continuing their leg drive.
And you could have somebody else come and hit him high.
That's right.
On second and seven, they keep it on the ground. Bowie. Good run, stays on his feet across midfield up the 49-yard line. And we speak so much about the arm strength of Geno Smith and the play of the receivers and Stedman Bailey and Tavon Austin. We've seen nice performances today by K.J. Myers and J.D. Woods and Ivan McCartney. But how about the running backs? I mean, you've got Sean Alston, who's over 100 yards. You've got Andrew Bowie, he's been strong. that bodes well for this West Virginia team throughout the year.
It sure does, because what it does is it takes the pressure off Geno Smith, the things that he wants to do, the things that they want to do offensively. But they're not afraid to mix it up and run the ball. You can tell today that they've really done what they wanted to.
A shovel pass to Jordan Thompson, which they usually run for Tavon Austin. It's going to be a loss of two on the play. Jermaine Holmes on the tackle. Don't forget, coming up next week, it is Miami traveling to Kansas State. We'll have that game at noon Eastern time, 11 Central on FX. Okay, with the last two games for this West Virginia team has not been too shabby offensively. 70 and now 69. Millard in the pocket, and he's going to get taken down for a sack.
Again, there's that clock in your head.
Jeremiah Taylor with the sack, a loss of four. And that's the difference. I mean, we saw before Geno Smith, the experience in the pocket. He had that clock running. He'd move out of the pocket, buy some more time, or maybe run with the ball. This time we saw Millard, who hasn't had much experience, sat in there too long.
It's good for him. They'll break this film down, and they'll go through some of these things, and he'll actually learn a lot from this game experience.
Millard able to keep it, push forward, pick up maybe a yard. Devin Arrington with a tackle. Fourth down is coming up, and this will be just the second punt of the game for Corey Smith. His first punt was blocked, which eventually led to a touchdown for Marshall.
You really saw them slow the offense down, too, trying to kind of burn this clock at this point in the game. And that's not what they're used to doing offensively.
They may have heard the warning by the PA announcer saying that the bad weather is 10 miles away, so they don't want to have any rain delays in this. This punt off. Snipes Booker, takes it at the nine. Booker all the way up to the 27-yard line. A 45-yard punt, a 19-yard return. Marshall and West Virginia with 6:25 to go. West Virginia leads 69-27. Now, I am not a weatherman, but the skies here in Morgantown don't look especially good. On first down, the handoff to Stewart. A lot of guys have been cramping up. Very humid out here today. It's one of those problems you see oftentimes early in the season. 69-27, West Virginia leading here. With just about 6 minutes to go in the ball game. Play action, the pass complete to C.J. Crawford. Crawford, the tight end. And he gets wrestled out at the 33-yard line, a pickup of seven. Anna Kyrum on the stop. Cato steps up over the middle, completes it again to C.J. Crawford. And another first down. Well, we looked at the upcoming schedule for West Virginia. How about for Marshall? Western Carolina, Ohio. We talked about Ohio before playing at Penn State. Rice, Purdue, and then their home against Tulsa on October 6th. Cato now taking his time. Time coming off the clock. Again, the play action, the pass is knocked down. Wes Tonkery able to break up that pass. Well, it looks like Darius Walker's noticed something about Rakeem Cato. What is it?
Yeah, hey, guys, you know, we talked earlier about him wearing the gloves and throwing the football. He has decided to take the gloves off. He's not wearing the gloves anymore. Not sure if this is a tester to see if what it feels like without the gloves or if he's trying to decide between the two, but no more gloves for Cato.
Maybe also he wants to be more fashionable.
Well, now he's using the towel that's on his belt.
Hand off, up the middle. Grooms on the carry.
If I'm Marshall's offense at this point, I'm really trying to get some guys in the game, get that young comfort level up, you know, where they can feel like, build the confidence in this first game. That's what they really need to do. Get those players in and out. Get the ball in all your receivers' hands, whether it's short passes. Get the ball in your running back's hands. Still kind of mix it up. Don't get too conservative at this point.
Rakeem Cato, good pass towards the far sideline. Devontae Allen with the catch. And Rakeem Cato has a new career high in passing yards. He is now at 373 on the day.
That doesn't surprise me that he's done that today. Off-season work, it's his second year in the system. The things that he's been able to do, yeah, this is a tough team to come in and play game one, but he's been throwing accurate balls. He had one interception, but that was off a deflected pass. He had a fumble that he held on the ball a little bit too long. But these are things that he can learn from. Go back and watch the film and learn from these things. But he's been accurate in his throws. I thought his footwork has been great. You know, for a sophomore, true sophomore quarterback, he's got a lot of bright games in front of him.
Butler on the carry. I mean, this is a kid in Rakeem Cato who has been through a lot in his life. Both of his parents died when he was a youngster. He was raised by his sister, who's just a couple years older than him. He grew up in Miami. Actually, one of his mentors growing up was Geno Smith, the quarterback for West Virginia. So these two guys are close. And you see the numbers he's put up. And last year, he was third among true freshmen as far as passing yards on the season, had over 2,500. One of the other freshmen in front of him was also from Miami, Teddy Bridgewater, who played at Louisville. So a couple of true freshmen out of the city of Miami made an impact as freshman quarterbacks in college football. Handoff once again is to Butler. Doc Holliday speaking to him yesterday. He was talking about what Rakeem Cato did last year coming into campus. He didn't come in early. He wasn't an early enrollee. He came in 2 weeks before school started when the football players report to school, and he started that very first game. So the only other guy I've seen do that, Phillip Rivers.
Yeah, it's an impressive. It's very difficult to do. No experience. You don't really know the team. You're really not the leader.
You did it, but you were a redshirt freshman. You weren't a true freshman.
You had a year to understand the system, get stronger. Everything that he's had to do while playing last year on the fly speaks volumes to the type of player he is, the commitment level that he's made. His teammates are surrounding him. They support him. He's not giving up tonight. You know, he's standing in there. He's throwing the ball, making completions. They're driving the ball down the field right now, even though this could be the last drive. He's still executing.
Cato rolls out to the right, throws to the end zone, and it is hauled in, but they're going to say it's incomplete as Tommy Shuler was out of bounds. West Tonkery there on the coverage. Day of the year in Columbus. Patrick O'Neill, Eddie George, and Joey Harrington will have that. They'll get you set for game two today on this doubleheader between Colorado and Colorado State. Fourth and 10. Marshall going for it, and why not? Cato has his man open, completes to Shuler, who got hit hard, but picks up the first down, sets up first and goal. Carl Joseph, the freshman free safety, with his fifth tackle of the game.
Well, a little surprising, too, that, you know, they're calling more penalties if you're defenseless. And there for a second, he kind of had his back to him. Carl Joseph on the play, making the tackle. Could have been questionable leading with his head.
On first and goal, the toss to Martin Ward, and Ward gets shoved out of bounds for a loss.
Oh, good job of stopping the clock, but not a good job of losing yards.
Tage Redmond on the tackle, a loss of five on the play. Right now, I think both coaches just want this clock to keep on moving. They don't want any weather issues to interrupt the end of this game. Pass is swung out, complete. to Jermaine Kelson. Carl Joseph right there, right away, this true freshman on the tackle. The first true freshman to start at safety for West Virginia since 2008 when Robert Sands was starting. That game coming up next, another in-state rivalry, Colorado and Colorado State. Third and 10, Cato, pass is incomplete, was intended for Demetrius Evans. Ishmael Banks there on the coverage.
You know, they want a touchdown so bad here, they're going for the end zone. Want to just finish the game here with a somewhat of a positive note. They know they're not gonna win the game, but scoring a touchdown, building up some confidence going into next week's game.
Cato rolling out, throws back across his body, wide open in the end zone, touchdown, Eric Fronapple. 11-yard completion for the touchdown.
And that's exactly what they wanted to do. Great job by Cato getting outside in the pocket. Really wasn't meant to do that, but he felt the pressure, got outside to keep the play alive, threw all the way across his body. That's one of the hardest things to do in football, and to be able to find a wide open receiver. Nice pass and catch.
The extra point is good. A touchdown for Marshall with under a minute to go, 69-34. Total points. Nice play right there. The front line. And West Virginia will be able to run out the clock. The hands team with Ryan Nealon making that play. Well, those 644 yards of offense for West Virginia, the record for them was 674, set back in 1923.
Well, it just shows you the talent that they have on offense. Not just Geno Smith, but the help that he gets at running back, the help that he gets at wide receiver, inside slot. More than just one running back. They've got three or four guys that they've got over 100 yards today.
Ballard play action. The pass is deflected and intercepted. Coming back the other way. Montarius Lovett, and a flag is thrown. I think some people are surprised right there about throwing when you're up 69-34 and under a minute to go.
Did they get what they deserve?
During the play, personal foul. Intercepting team, number 97. 15-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. It'll be Marshall's ball, first and 10.
We've seen a lot of those penalties today, personal fouls, penalties against Marshall. And interesting call here. Throwing the football with this much time. Good focus and concentration on that football to really come up with a big play at the end of the game. Almost scored a touchdown.
KJ Myers was the intended receiver. He's the one who bobbled it and then intercepted by Montarius Lovett.
Daniel Hogerson probably wishes he could take that one back.
Blake Fronapple now in at quarterback here for Marshall. Hands off to Kevin Grooms. And Grooms gets taken down by Redmond and Nana Crum. Blake Fronapple, the brother of Eric Fronapple, the tight end.
Fronapple, a freshman. Good to get a freshman in case something were to happen down the road.
Quarterback keeper. Wes Tonkery with a tackle. Rakeem Cato, his day is done. A new career high for him.
Not the happiest look on his face, but did everything he could.
Fronapple steps up, and he throws that out of bounds with 2 seconds on the game clock. 69-34. Number 11, West Virginia flexed their muscles, showing off what everyone has been speaking about, that offense.
Will Joe DeForest be happy that 34 points were scored on his defense today?
I don't think he'll be too happy, as that pass is incomplete, and that will do it. The last game of this rivalry comes to an end as West Virginia defeats Marshall 69-34. You just saw Geno Smith go over to shake Doc Holliday's hand. That's because Doc Holliday was the coach who actually recruited him to West Virginia. But the quest to enter the Big 12 for West Virginia here in 2012 off to a good start. A 69-34 victory over their in-state rival. Let's head back to Patrick O'Neill in our studio for the AT&T Fox College Saturday Game Break Show.